What's up, guys? Sunny with God's Love and Harmony. You know what I'm saying? Also known as Set Free. It's the voice of the inner city, man. We're going to start this thing off today with Psalms 3. All right. You guys ready for it? We can get straight into it. First, Father God, thank you for this day. Bless these words. Bless the listener. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Lord, how many are my foes? How many rise up against me? Many are saying of me, God will not deliver him. But you, Lord, are a shield around me. My glory, the one who lifts my head up high. I call out to the Lord, and he answers me from his holy mountain. I lie down and sleep. I wake again because the Lord sustains me. I will not fear though tens of thousands assail me on every side. Arise, Lord, deliver me, my God. Strike all my enemies on the jaw. Break the teeth of the wicked. From the Lord comes deliverance. May your blessings be on your people. Let me hit it for you guys one more time. This is Psalms 3. You guys want to get it in real quick? Lord, how many are my foes? How many rise up against me? Many are saying of me, God will not deliver him. But you, Lord, are a shield around me. My glory, the one who lifts my head high. I call out to the Lord, and he answers me from his holy mountain. I lie down and sleep. I wake again because the Lord sustains me. I will not fear though tens of thousands assail me on every side. Arise, Lord, deliver me, my God, and strike all my enemies on the jaw. Break the teeth of the wicked. From the Lord comes deliverance. May your blessings be on your people. I don't know why the sounds in my headphones are tripping again. Anyways, that was the word of the Lord today. You know, I'm having a lot of fun with this camera. You know, got a new toy, so we have to keep it lit. You know what I'm saying? So what stood out to me was, that he's a shield around me. My glory, the one who lifts my head up high. I'll call out to the Lord, and he answers me from a holy mountain. So I like, he says he lays down and sleeps. I wake up again because the Lord sustains me. I will not fear, though tens of thousands assail me on every side. Arise, Lord, deliver me, my God. Strike all my enemies on the jaw. Break the teeth of the wicked. From the Lord comes deliverance. May your blessings be on your people. You kind of get more intimate with God when you start realizing who your God is. You start seeing what kind of things are saying in here. Like, strike my enemies on the jaw. Break the teeth of the wicked. From the Lord comes deliverance. May your blessings be on your people. On his people. You know what I'm saying? So there's a line right there. Like, there's some that are not his people. I mean, I'm not saying that he's saying that there's, you know, but I mean, be blessed. Be blessed, my brothers and sisters. We are God's people. We are God's chosen people. How glorious and good it is to say the name of the Lord and to have refuge in his wings. I mean, just to know that God is good. I am so glad and glad that my God has surrounded us by his love. And has graciously forgiven us for our sins and showed it as a public display for all to see forever and ever. And everyone sees a cross and hears the story of Jesus Christ. That is an awesome love that goes through generations to generations. He made sure he made a public display for the rest of our lives. People are going to see what Jesus Christ has done for us. I'm not in a hurry for him to come back. I want more people and more people to see and live through and see who Jesus is and what they done. I see them crosses. I see them rainbows. I see them promises. I see them words. I thank you, God. Anytime the enemy try to use something against, the enemy always going to try to use something that God has against God. Like, he try to take the rainbow for these dudes that dress up like women. Right? Or trying to attract a man by looking like a woman, but don't want to live like, you know, and this is not like, you know, it's just kind of crazy how that works. And then the cross, and then they put one upside down. But stop stealing our stuff. You know what I'm saying? Stop trying to use stuff that is ours. It's like, people don't celebrate Halloween. It's like, first of all, it's not nobody's, it's God's. Like, no matter what it is, you say, oh, it started from this and that. But guess what it is now? We just stole it. You know, now kids celebrate, you know, dressing up. You know what I mean? It ain't like we're all just sitting at home brewing witchcraft brews and making spells and taking home books and doing crazy stuff like that. It's not, no, we, like that, you know, they say people are gingerfied, right? But, well, guess what? We stole the evilness and turned it into good. Like, you know, we could take our kids out and have fun. So whatever it was, like we big stepping, big holy stepping, amen? So we got our Christmas. They try to do that to Easter, too. They try to say something about Easter, how bad it was, all this and that. Well, guess what? We use it for the risen. You know what I'm saying? Like, guess what? Every time the enemy try to take something and say it's bad, guess what? We turn to good. Amen? God always said I turn from beauty from ashes. You know what I'm saying? And that's what that is. And that's what he did with us. And that's what he did with me. You seen the person I was. It's like, yeah, I look kind. Maybe sometimes I smile and stuff. But inside, yucky, yucky, yucky man. Boogie, boogie man. I was a boogie man. But the Lord used me, though. He said, nah, not no more. Bam. And he ain't just like, it's not like, oh, cool, I just got a ghetto pass. He corrected me. His anger rose up against me. And not only that, he had generous mercy on me. They say he's rich in mercy, you know. And he sent me to. He's done some things with me, man. He is a glorious father. And he is a just father, I'll tell you that. All glory to God. All glory to God. Man, so many things I could just. Just thankful that he is forgiving me and stuff. Man, right now, you know who's on my mind right now? Brother Mike. I don't know why. I'm just thinking about Brother Mike. Brother Mike, you know what? You're on my mind right now. Man, maybe I think that word actually just hit me right now today. I think God revealed it to me that maybe might have been when I was prophesying, God was bringing a word through me. It was actually... I didn't have the name of the father in my head of what children it was, but now it hit me. That's the trip kind of like trembling right now. Like that, I think God was prophesying to you, Brother Mike. I don't know if you're tuning into this thing, but it's one of these videos where at the end where God was bringing something about somebody's daughter, bro, and that's a trip. And now I think about it, God just brought it to me. It's talking about you. I don't know, but. But I don't know what I said in the last video, but I remember God said he was going to bring something in the next video. Wow, that's a trip. Just right here live on this video, you guys can hear that, bro. You can hear the last video, and God started speaking, like, you know, prophetically to me. Through me, I mean, and speaking about somebody's daughter, and he's even talking about, like, that's a trip, man. And then right now, I was like, and there's something on my mind where let me go that it was Brother Mike right now. I was like, hey, Brother Mike just kept hitting me right now. So if you listen, Brother Mike, man, God's got something in store. That means he's got your child. He's got your child like he's the father. You know what I'm saying? Because he is the father. But you know what I mean? He's taking very good care of, like, a good, close personal relationship with her. He's watching over. And you ain't got nothing to worry about. He said there might be some worries that you had and some fears, but God said, don't worry. You know what I'm saying? Do not worry one so bit that he is 100%. She is on his chessboard and he's the one moving the pieces. Amen. And you might think, oh, you might worry if she's a pawn or some of the pawns gets it across the board. You get turned them into a queen. You know what I'm saying? But of course she is a queen, but you know what I mean? They say the most deadliest piece on the thing is a pawn. It's the most powerful one too. That's the one that protects the king and queen. That protects the mom and dad. Amen. Protects the heavenly father. I mean, God don't need no protection, but you know what I mean. He is the protection. But I don't know. But thanks you for tuning in. Shout out to my brother Tom, SB Spirit Bully. Shout out to the Reno home. You know what I'm saying, out in Reno. Amen. Should I see you guys out there? Reno, the Cap City region. You know what I'm saying? The brothers in Stockton. Victory Ivory South Shack. You know what I'm saying? David from West Shack. What's up? I see you out there. Brother Henry, you know, you always on here. You know what I'm saying? Brother Brandy, North Sack Deep. You know what I'm saying? VO North Sack. That's where I was in the home at. People that didn't know, I was in the home in North Sacramento, and that's where God called me. It's prophetic, too, because I remember typing in South Sacramento Victory Outreach. So before I went to the home, because my girl wanted me to go home because I had a drug addiction. I couldn't shake it. So I looked it up. I called the number that popped up on the screen for the thing. I remember clicking on it. They answered the phone. I'm like, hey, what's up? I want to join you guys' program or whatever I need. They kind of like stopped me right there. I'm like, what? He's like, where you at? And I'm like, what do you mean where I'm at? I'm still thinking I got to explain the process, you know, to get in the program. I'm like, well, hey, you know, yeah, it's kind of. So, no, but like, where you at? You went, things like, all right, well, you asked a couple of questions. Like, are you a sex offender? No. Okay, can you walk? I forgot what he asked me, but, and he's like, can you work? I think he's like, can you work? So I was like, yeah, I can work. He's like, all right, we'll be right there. I was like, what? I was like, yeah, I told him I was by some parking. Dude, I guess, knew, like, heck of a second. He's like, yeah. I know exactly where you're across the street, right there, that one house. I'm like, what? Sure enough, like 15 minutes later, van pulls up, brrr, Victory Outreach in the thing. Come on, where's your stuff at? I'm like, damn, like, I don't even have an ID. I don't even got an ID. Y'all just gonna take me in? Yeah, let's go. Come on. I'm like, wait, don't you guys need me to have like some kind of test or like, because I know when I was trying to go to other programs, they needed to have like a tetanus shot or you have to have some kind of shot. And I was like, nah, I was like, nah, man, come on, just go. I said, for real? I was like, all right, I get there. Sure, they hand me some clothes, hand me, you know, a towel and stuff, some hygiene. Assign me a warm bed. And I'm like, wait, okay. He's like, boom. All right, here's your Bible. I'm like, all right, let's do this, man. So I flowed right in. I seen a bunch of cats come and leave nonstop. 2-3 days, they come in to get right. You know what I'm saying? They come in, eat, sleep. They get grace for 3 days. They come in, they get sleep and eat all they want. But you know, after 3 days, you got to get up and participate. A lot of cats, they'll try to stay after 4 or 5 days, and they're like, hey, man, I'm bounced. I'm like, all right. You know, brother, wish you wouldn't. You know, but I hope you stay, blah, blah, blah. But, man, as soon as my 7th day there, God gave me a scripture, told me, don't worry about temptations. You're going to find a way out. Say he's going to make a way out. And I was like, it hit my heart so in such a way. It was like tapping on my chest, like I'm talking to you. I'm like, oh, shoot. And ever since then, I just believed it. And how many know faith moves mountains? How many know if I didn't believe that he was saying, I'm talking to you, that don't worry about temptation, I would have ran into that mountain again. But because I have faith that he tapped me and said, this is for you. He's talking to me. And there's nothing you can do when someone really believes something. Like, no, you know, like you know when you truly believe something, there's nothing they can tell you. Like try, some people try to say, oh, there's no such thing as, like someone might tell you, no such thing as good luck. Or some of the people might tell you there's no such thing as God. Or yeah, or something. But you know there is a God. And then, like, you know, there ain't no such thing as like, you're like, man, God is God. And you're like, there's nothing else they could tell you. And I had 100% belief without a doubt. And then he always says that if you can believe without a doubt, you can move a mountain. I know how glorious God is. I'm just thinking about that right now, how good God is. Man, shoot. I just thought about that, though. If you believe without a doubt, you can move mountains. And I believed that he said, this verse is for you. He hit me in the chest. And ever since then, I even packed up my bags. I went and said, hey, pastor, man, hey, church, man, you know what? God did his work, man. I'm out of here. I know I'm going to be clean for the rest of my life. And how many of you know that was 4 years ago? That was 4 years ago, bro. January 9th was when I went to the men's home. It's already December, 4 years later. You know what I'm saying? How many know that I packed in my bags, I went out to surpass, I'm good. God gave me the word, but you know what, they prayed me out, whatever, and I went home. My wife's like, look, I had a check. I had money. I had some money. My employer wasn't trying to give my check to my girl. So I picked up the check, got it. You know what I'm saying? God told me to buy a couple things, a couple outfits and stuff. But he said the rest is good to your girl. So bam, I gave the rest to my girl. And then I don't know how much it was. It wasn't that much. You know, I wasn't making that much. And I went to men's home. And bro, she told me to go back because she's like, hey, stay the process. I said, no, God gave me a word. I'm telling you I'm good. She said, no, I want you to go back. And I want you to do this program. I go, okay. All right. I was home or whatever. You know what I'm saying? And I packed my bags this time. You know, I didn't get to really pack my bags. That's the first time because that's when my girl locked me out. And she's like, she didn't even let me get my stuff or nothing. She just went arguing with me, no fighting, no nothing. She's like, no. You tell me to use one more time. That's it. She locked the doors. I was banging on the windows, banging on the doors, trying to get crazy, trying to, and then begging, come on, and trying to put the sad on her, you know, instead of trying to put the bum on her. I tried every little thing, every tactic I could. She just wasn't giving in. So, anyways, I went back to the men's zone, bro. and even then, while I was in there, I was like, at the time, I was like, oh, maybe I'm good. But then right when I thought I was going to be done, Sister Mary, as Pastor Christian's wife, turned to me during the service. She's like, if you think you're going to lead this program right now, don't. God just told me, one of you guys are trying to lead the program, don't. You're going to sit right here. When someone tell you to go home, that's when you go home. Okay, that's when someone told. And then her husband was, I remember he was preaching to me one time. He's like, okay, when is the sign to go home? God said, when they tell you to go home, that's when the sign is. When they tell you to go home, that's when God wants you to go home. And I was just thinking about that. Like, I remember staying and I remember asking, come on, baby, you want to go home? And like, nah, you guys stay through the process. You know what I mean? It's a process you got to go through. I'm like, and then you know what? I thought about it. I go, man, and I believed it. I go, yeah, you're right. It is a process. Okay, I'm going to stay the process, babe. And then a couple weeks later, she's like, hey, maybe you could come home. And I'm like, boom, bam. I'm like, all right. She's like, no, not right now. She's like, but maybe, you know, she's like, let's prepare before you come home. Sure enough, she told me that my son was crying because he missed me. She was like, you know, son, he's crying. He's like, I want my daddy. And I was out working. We were setting up the 4th of July booths. And after I got this 4th of July booth up. I remember I put the 4th of July booth up. I just couldn't stop. I almost walked off the job site and went straight home. I was thinking about my boy. I said, nah, don't do it like that. Don't do it the wrong way. I waited till we got back. I say, Pastor, I'm saying, I want to go home, man. My boy, you know, has been on my mind, been on my heart. You know, he ain't been with his dad. He's been crying for me and stuff. So, you know, I'm going to pack up my bags. And he's like, oh, man, you know. Oh, man. You know, but he said, look, don't tell the guys I'm praying you out. I'm going to pray. Come on, I'm going to get the guys. We're going to pray over you. And, yeah, I went home, man. And sure enough, it was the perfect timing. How you know everything's on due season? Well, I believe truly that because I was willing to stay through the process. That was the process key right there that was in my heart. He's like, look, I seen your heart. We need to stay the process, but I do need you to come home now. The work has been done, you know? And I came home. My boy was sitting on the couch with his iPad, and my phone call was upstairs. So I'm knocking on the door. I'm like, knock, knock. I'm like, he's like, who is it? But I'm like, Sonny. He's like, oh, who's that, Dad? I'm like, yeah, it's Dad. Oh, man, I'm not supposed to open the door, but for you, I'll open it, okay? I go, okay. And I was like, man, that was such a good boy. I see his mom had him trained, like, you know, don't open the door for nobody. She's like, all right. And he's like, Dad, I'm not supposed to open the door, but for you, I'll open the door. And I was so proud of even saying that, you know? And I had my stuff on the porch, and I could buy it in. My girl didn't know, and I was around the house. I was, you know, I think I cooked something or did something cool. And she walked in the door, and she was like, why are you here? But you could hear, like, her excitement but confusion at the same time. Why are you here? I was like, I'm home. She's like, what? Oh, no, for real? And I'm like, yeah, I'm home. And she's like, I was like, I came home. And she's like, all right. You know? And I stayed plugged in, though, man. I started going to church all the time. I'm talking about, like, even Holy Ghost Thursdays. We didn't have nothing to do. Not nothing to do. Like, if I didn't have no work, like, Holy Ghost Thursdays, prayer night, service night, classes, you know what I'm saying? Just fellowshipping, whatever it was, you know what I'm saying? And when I did have a job, I remember making a little bit of money, you know what I'm saying? I started tying my 10%. Boom, boom, boom. God just, boom, blessing me. Bro, I had no license. I had no car, nothing. When I came in the house. I ain't work for nothing, man. God was working, but God brought all the extras. He really did. You know what I'm saying? God brought all the extras. He really did. I'm truly above, beyond blessed. I did nothing. God, like, literally, like, you think, like, how you gonna get something with nothing? God literally said, my blessings will be chasing you. That means no matter where I go, I can't outrun God. That means, you know what I'm saying? His blessings are going to be like, it's like a hunting, but the other way, the opposite, you know what I'm saying? And then, I don't know, man, God gave me a word and a promise, man, one day, man, I'm going to be doing big things, man, one day, man, but, you know, I don't want to put that out there, but, like, I'm like, what? It doesn't even feel like big things, but it does feel like big things. God's putting stuff in the works where it's like, well, God's like, you're doing big stuff, huh, God? And I smell the rock cooking, you know what I'm saying? I'm like, oh, man, I feel the cooking, man. I see what you're doing, man. I know he gave me the vision, man. He gave me a scene. He let me talk to certain people, man. I'm like, God. You know what I'm saying? It's, like, amazing. And it's the trip because it's all God, man. It really is. And man. I just want to get tears of joy right now. My God is so good. My God is so good. He really is. And he's rich of mercy, too. You know, and he's gracious. And that's a big part about it. He's been really patient with me. But there's some times when he's like, you know you're supposed to be doing this. And I'm like, oh. And I so he was shaking my whole life. Like, okay, hey, babe, I'm going to be doing this. Like, literally, like when a parent comes in your room with the belt, and you know you were leaving the house dirty or whatever, and just going to start whooping your butt. Like, all right. I know I'm supposed to be reading more. I'm supposed to be praying more. I know. Like, literally, he like chases me and kicks my butt and stuff. And, you know, he tightens you up, like he said, he'll humble you. And at the same time, it feels like, yeah. I don't know, but that's a good relationship, man, to have with the Father, though. I really, really love it, and I appreciate it. But, yeah, man, it's a good little time to tap in. I'm going to keep coming out here with little live scenarios, little stories and stuff, little testimonies. He says, we overcome with the power of our testimony and by the blood of God. You know what I'm saying? So, amen, man. I just... grateful to give another little testimony and stuff. Matter of fact, this might be named the testimony / Proverbs 3. Stories were set free, man. Oh, excuse me. Stories were set free. Real life stories. Amen, amen. Well, brothers and sisters in Christ, all those, share this video. You know, it might actually, God just tell you to share the video. And it's for the glory of God. It's like right now I'm not gonna benefit from it, but someone else is, and so will you, and there's like a family saying there's a family out there, a dad or someone in the same shoes, but that hasn't made it there yet, but just would love to like it's like fellowshipping with me, but like I don't know, guys will do like impartations, kind of like I don't have to be there right there with them, but the Spirit's here with them, whoever's gonna hear it. So if that could happen right now, that would be great. In the mighty name of Jesus. Samuel, if you're hearing this, somebody named Samuel, you know what I'm saying? There's a reason I say that name, but don't know, maybe some of Pastor Sam or something. But yeah, but man, I got some books. I'm gonna read them out to you guys sometime. I'm gonna read from them pages too. We just get it in, but yeah, man. Yeah, check it out, man. So I don't know what God said that. My Pastor Sam, I think he's talking about Pastor Sam Rodriguez and South Sac. They got a church out there too. Cause we gotta promote the body. You know what I'm saying? That's a really good church too. I go to that church. A lot of prophetic stuff's going on there. A lot of word from God, and they had classes there and stuff. I mean, it's pretty out there. You know what I'm saying? And God is good. God is good. God is good. God is good all the time. All the time. All the time. God's good all the time. God is good. Love you guys, man. Sonny was set free from God's loving harmony, the voice in the inner city. Right here tapping in with you, man. I love you and I thank you guys. And don't be afraid to step out on faith. You know what I'm saying? Standing up for yourself and correcting people. In the mighty name of Jesus, you belong to God. You're God's people. You're as bold as lions. God's people are as bold as lions, he says. All right, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.